The water quality in some streams around Toronto has been compromised because it flows through heavily urbanized areas. Soil erosion, salt runoff from roads, water temperature increase from storm runoffs, and other factors all make it hard for fish to live and spawn successfully in these streams. The Ringwood Fish Culture Station's main goal is to raise and release salmon and trout to help supplement and maintain healthy fish populations in areas like these. Without the efforts of volunteer groups like the Metro East Anglers in stocking these fish, naturalized fish populations in compromised streams would eventually disappear. The Ringwood Fish Culture Station is located in Stouffville, Ontario. It is here where the volunteers from the Metro East Anglers rear salmon and trout from eggs to fingerlings before releasing them back into the tributaries of Lake Ontario. The Ringwood Fish Culture Station consists of two main buildings, the first being the hatchery itself, and the second being an aeration building. The aeration building is at the heart of the process. This is where the operation's lifeblood, or natural water, is tapped from three artesian wells under the ground. The naturally pressurized water flows from the wells at up to 3,000 liters per minute and travels through piping to a set of aeration towers. It is in these towers that the water's oxygen levels are increased and nitrogen levels decreased to provide water that is more conducive to the healthy rearing of salmon and trout. This highly oxygenated water then flows into cisterns and is piped from the aeration building over to the hatchery. Once in the hatchery, the water is mechanically diverted as required to the incubation trays, sorting trays, early rearing tanks, advanced rearing tanks, and finally to outflow piping where the young fish are transferred into a tank for transport to the rivers. The clean discharge water from this process is then sent through outflow piping to a small stream adjacent to the hatchery building. The complete rearing process can take between 6 and 8 months depending upon the species of fish being reared. Let's examine each step of the hatchery's rearing process in more detail. The first step of this process involves the collection of male and female salmon specimens, in this case coho salmon, from specially developed pens located in fish ladders on tributaries of Lake Ontario. The fish that are trapped in these pens are collected using nets and transferred to a main staging area. Another method used to harvest the fish is by shocking them with low voltage. This is done in the main river and the fish ladder spillway. The disoriented fish are then also scooped into nets and carried to the staging area. Once in the main staging area, the fish are put into holding vessels and sorted by species and gender. The male coho salmon are then wiped clean and thoroughly dried before being milked for their sperm. The sperm packs, which were previously labeled to identify the donors, are placed into a cooler in preparation for their journey to the hatchery. Eggs are then collected from the females and are also placed into individually labeled plastic tubs, which are also put into coolers for transport. Coho salmon are not repeat spawners. Their life cycle is such that they live for only 4 years and die soon after spawning. In Toronto area streams, their eggs would have a very low chance of survival, with less than 1% making it to the fry stage. By taking the eggs back to the hatchery, the survival rate increases to over 80%, getting these eggs through the critical and sensitive early stages of development. The donor carcasses are then cataloged and sent to a nearby university for analysis. The unfertilized eggs and the sperm are then transported to the Ringwood Fish Culture Station. Once in the hatchery, the eggs are fertilized by mixing them with the sperm and water. Accurate records are kept indicating the individual donors of both sperm and eggs. The association between eggs and sperm occurs very rapidly. The eggs are then moved to the incubation room, where they are rinsed thoroughly in an ovidine solution for approximately 1 hour. This process removes any contaminants or external diseases that may be present on the eggs. The eggs are then rinsed in fresh running water for an additional hour to remove the ovidine solution and flush away any impurities. Each container is then meticulously checked for unfertilized eggs, referred to as bullets. These bullets appear white in color and are removed from the fertilized eggs and discarded. The remaining fertilized eggs are then counted to determine the eggs per liter ratio and ultimately the actual number of eggs per container, which is then recorded. The eggs are then poured into incubation trays, where they will continue to develop, thus completing the first cycle of their lives. Weeks later, the eggs hatch and the sac fry are monitored in the incubation trays as they feed on the nutrients in the egg sac still attached to them. As the fry grow larger and the nutrients are completely absorbed, the fish must be transferred to the early rearing tanks. Here they will be fed a specially formulated, controlled diet as they continue to develop. Before entering the early rearing tanks, the fry are released from the incubation trays into sorting tanks, where their overall health is assessed. Any unhatched eggs or fish who had not absorbed their egg sacs completely are removed from the main population. Small samples of fish are then removed from the tub, dried off, and then poured into another container on a scale in 25 to 50 gram batches. These samples are then taken to the early rearing tanks, where the fish are counted as they are released into the tanks. This allows the hatchery volunteers to calculate the average weight of each fish. This process is repeated 4 or 5 more times until the unit weight is verified as being consistent. All of the remaining fish are then scooped into one container and weighed. The total weight of the fish is recorded, and based on the previously calculated weight per fish, the total number of fish being released into the early rearing tanks is calculated and also documented. The type and quantity of feed required at this stage of the fish's life is calculated based on the size and species of the fish. The feed is precisely measured into plastic containers, which are used to load the automatic feeders at each of the early rearing tanks. The automatic feeders release the feed continuously on a 12-hour schedule, and this will continue until the fish reach fingerling size and are ready to be transferred to the advanced rearing tanks. When the fish reach 3 to 4 inches in length, they are transferred from the incubation room into 16,000-liter tanks referred to as the advanced rearing tanks. Water continuously circulates through these tanks and is renewed every hour. This is the last stage of the rearing cycle, and the fish will remain in these tanks for approximately 6 months until they've reached a size where they can be released into the rivers. Before being released, 10 to 15 sample batches of fish are weighed and counted to determine the average weight per fish. Once the average weight is established, the fish are scooped into a graduated bucket, 10 kilograms at a time. This allows the volunteers at the hatchery to determine the total number of fish being released, and ultimately determine the ratio of fish released to eggs originally incubated. Next, the fish are poured into a trough connected to an outflow pipe that sends the fish to an aerated tank on a trailer in preparation for transport to their release destination. After a short drive, the fish arrive at one of the many release destinations on a Lake Ontario tributary. With the help of volunteers from the community, a number of these fish are carried to the water's edge in buckets, where they are released. The remaining fish are released through a discharge tube on the back of the trailer directly into the water. Most of these fish will migrate downstream to Lake Ontario. Here, they will thrive as part of a renewed fish population that will be enjoyed by all outdoor enthusiasts for years to come.